Hi everyone, it's been a while since I've done a video update. We didn't get around to doing a podcast this episode, so instead I thought I'd give you an update this way. Not covering any particular topics of discussion, but a lot has been happening with the game. As you know, we've got the really big next update planned. And work on that's been going pretty well. Last night I got a prototype of the magic shops working, and the thieves guilds are in place, and oh god, what else have we done? We've changed mana potions, as you've heard in the, and health potions, as you've heard in the podcast. Next thing I'm working on is the aviaries and the quick travel system, which I'm sure you guys will love. I hate to think what's going to happen when Smega gets released onto the quick travel system. Brace yourselves, Smega is coming. And there's a new shopkeeper being added, called the Cartographer, and he will map out areas for you and show you where to go, because the gazetteers of Smega are handy, but they are sort of limited to you being in the area. So if you have a mind to explore a particular place, as a lot of people have been doing, and that's why the cartographer is being added, but you'll be able to look at the whole world map and pick a place that you want to be mapped out for you, and you'll pay to have all of the cities mapped out, or all of the dungeons, or you'll pay, you know, to have everything mapped out if you want, but there'll probably be a bulk discount. But this is in-game gold, by the way, not real money. But yeah, the voice work and artwork are done for him. It just needs to be implemented. The user interface for the cartographer will be very similar to the aviary, so should be able to get both of them done in one fell sweep. The Thieves Guild has been an interesting test, because it's our first guild that we've done. And it will be the template upon which the other guilds are built. So that's been fairly interesting to get working, and it's not entirely working yet, but most of it's there. And one thing that was requested by the community was that you want a practice mode for the trap disarming. Some people just love playing that mini game, which is cool, so you'll be able to do that at the Thieves Guild. Won't give you any stat boosts or anything like that, but it'll just be fun to play if you just want to sit there for an evening playing that for some reason. Some people are into it. I think it was Aliophius that asked for that, but correct me if I'm wrong. So yeah, all that's been going on. We've been putting in some groundwork for magical enemies, though they're a while away before you'll see them, but the groundwork is being put into place for them. What else have we got? We're putting in mega chests at the bottom floor of every dungeon. Will be randomly allocated on the bottom floor. If it's a one-floor dungeon, the chest won't be really that grand, but if it's a 10-floor dungeon, if you get down there, you'll really, really be rewarded for making it all the way to the bottom, especially since monsters are quite difficult at that point. So it's sort of like a bit like how in Diablo 2, when you'd kill the boss monster, and everything would start spewing out all this gear and loot and gold and things like that. So that's going to happen with these mega chests that are going in there. Also, the quest format is being changed. Instead of getting them from NPCs, because I know there's a lot of problems with you getting a quest from an NPC, going and doing the quest and coming back, and they've buggered off and they're not there anymore. So what's going to happen is every town will have a kiosk that you go to, and it's sort of like a notice board where when people need something doing, they'll put a request there. So you'll go there and say, you know, what's on the list to do. This way will be a little bit easier as well, and nicer, because you'll be able to pick and choose which quests you do. Not so much a big issue now, because there's only two quest types, but eventually there's going to be about 20 quest types. And some people are just going to really hate fetch quests, which I know is a big irk in the RPG community, so you'll be able to actually choose not to do any quest types that are fetch quests. Technically, you can do that now by just deleting a quest that you get, but I think it'd be nicer to actually go and be able to choose your quests rather than just be given a quest and then have to organize your quest log after that. So little things like that to make things just easier for you. We also want to put in quick keys for drinking potions, because we are active on the forums, even if the team isn't always commenting on things. We read pretty much everything, and we've been seeing that people... The main strategy is basically buy as many health potions as you possibly can and just spam them during combat. So we want to make that easy for you and put in hotkeys. So it'll basically drink the highest value potion that you currently hold when you press one key, and then the highest value mana potion that you hold when you press the other key. Just so you don't have to keep opening your inventory, clicking on the potion, drinking it, and so on and so forth. So that should make your combat experience a little bit better. Also looking to add more spell effects, just to make combat a little bit more interesting, and dungeoneering in general a little more interesting. And my plate has been really full. It was my birthday this week, just gone on Thursday, so I took a little bit of time off. I know, pretty rare for me, but really felt like I deserved it after the amount of work I've been doing. But I'm back on the horse and slogging away at getting this stuff done. So if I can get things stable enough, I may do a partial release again instead of making you wait ages until the full update is out. Because some of the things that they're playing with are just too fun. For example, Blatherbeard's Brew is now in the game, and you can use alchemy to brew potions of your own. And one of the potions you can brew is Blatherbeard's Brew, which I think is a unicorn urine, serpent spittle, and troll snot is what you mix together to make Blatherbeard's Brew. And if you drink it, you become 5 times as strong. Every hit you do does 5 times as much damage. However, you stop being aware of damage to yourself because you're in that blind rage stage of being drunk, so every hit that you take from the enemy is 3 times greater. So it can be good, can be bad. The most interesting thing about it is if you drink a second bottle of Blatherbeard's Brew while you're already drunk from the first bottle, you will black out completely and somehow get out of whatever conundrum you are in. Doesn't matter if you're surrounded by ogres, you'll manage to escape from it. The only thing is, you will have a moment a bit like getting drunk in taverns, so you will black out and get out of your situation, but you may wake up in a desert with no pants. You know, you never know what's going to happen. So it's like most things with Malevolence, most of the good things come with a downside as well. The testers have been playing around with Tears of Hervidler, and I've been getting some really good feedback on the usefulness of those. Recall medallions have been recoded quite a bit, but they're still able to be used to bail out of a rough situation in a dungeon, and seems to be the main use of them, actually. Rather than just getting out of a dungeon quickly, it's a get-out-of-jail-free card, basically. And a couple of major bugs have been fixed lately, including one that actually was stopping some downstairs entrances in dungeons being spawned. So that means that dungeon that you might have found that has 3 floors might actually have 7 floors, and you just never knew it. That was leading to some people having cleanse quests not being finished, because they scoured the entire floor and found no stairs down, so they thought that they'd finished the dungeon. But actually it was a bug in the game not placing that stairs down. That's been fixed now, so that should fix that problem as well. Let me know. Comment if you would like to see another mini update once we get it stable, or whether or not you want to just be hit with the giant update, which will be as soon as we possibly can do it. But it likely will be around the end of the month, because the update that we're working on now, if we wait until the final thing, that's going to move the game to a almost finished state. The only thing left to do will be tidying up a few extra bugs and adding new quest types and spells. The rest of the content will be in place, so let us know. I mean, you guys seem to love the updates, but and you may prefer to get lots of small updates rather than, you know, several big updates. So I don't know unless you tell me, so comment. And let me know, because I really like hearing from you guys. I love the community that we've built, or I should say you guys have built. I love how autonomous you've become. A lot of the times tech support things are handled by you, and I love that. I love scouring through the Show Us Your Find forum and look at the random locations that you guys have found. Every time some people have found really odd things that the procedural generation has created, they post a screenshot. It's one of my favorite things, seeing some of the things that you guys find. So yeah, definitely get on that, because it makes me smile when new posts get put in that forum. Keep up the good work on your end with all the playing. Something like 11,000 unique locations found. That's going to skyrocket once the quick travel goes in. I'm really looking forward to that. The black market trade and the dimension stone seems to be going well, although there seems to be a little bit of a glitch where sometimes items disappear. I am sorry about that. We are working on it. But there's over 80 dimension stones being regularly used, so that's quite impressive, given how far apart they are. One of them's actually submerged. And on my birthday, I put a special birthday blade of LAX in one of the dimension stones, and Kneecleaver found it, so congratulations to him. So yeah, I'll get back to work, because I know you're probably screaming at the screen, "What are you doing talking to us when you should be working?" I'll get back to work. I've got a long night ahead of me of this, after my time off for my birthday, and yeah, I've got lots of fun things to do. You guys are going to absolutely love the Cartographer's voice pack. It was done by Benjamin Irvine, who also voiced the slightly crazy hero character. And he also is the General Store character. You're going to love the character that he's come up with. I piss myself laughing every time I hear the lines, so hopefully you guys like it as much. So until then, I will catch you all later.